Uniform circular motion. Uniform motion and understanding circular motion. Before starting the lecture, click on the subscribe button and get access to our 100 of conceptual lectures for free. Now, what is uniform motion? To understand uniform motion, you must understand speed and velocity. We know that speed is a scalar quantity. Thus, it has only size or magnitude. For example, 12 meter per second is speed of a car. But velocity is a vector quantity. It has both magnitude and proper direction. For example, 12 meter per second towards north is velocity of a car. Now, to simplify this concept further, let's consider four points. A, B, C, and D. Let a car moves from point A to the point B. Then this car moves from point B to the point C. At last, the car moves from point C to the point D. Let from point A to point B, the car covers displacement S is equal to 12 meter and time T is equal to 2 second. From point B to point C, the car again covers displacement S is equal to 12 meter and time T is equal to 2 seconds. From point C to point D, car covers displacement S is equal to 24 meter and time T is equal to 4 second. Now we know that velocity is equal to displacement upon time taken. The velocity of a car from point A to point B is 12 meter divided by 2 seconds and it is equal to 6 meter per second. The velocity of a car from point B to point C is 12 meter divided by 2 second is again 6 meter per second. And the velocity of a car from point C to point D is 24 meter divided by 4 second is again 6 meter per second. Thus, the velocity of the car is 6 meter per second from point A to point B, then from point B to point C, and then from point C to point D. What this 6 meter per second means? Well, it means that from point A to point D, your car covers 6 meter displacement in every second. Or you can say that your car covers equal displacement in equal interval of time in a proper straight direction. Therefore, when an object covers equal distance in equal interval of time, we call that body possesses uniform speed. Hence, this car is in uniform speed. What about uniform velocity? For uniform velocity, a body must cover equal displacement in equal interval of time in one proper direction. Here, the car covers equal displacement of 6 meter every second in this single or one direction. Hence, both the magnitude of velocity is 6 meter per second and this car has only one direction. Thus, this car also possesses uniform velocity. Here, let me ask you a very important question. How does velocity change? Do you know the answer? Well, you must know the answer of this question. Otherwise, you will not be able to learn any uniform motion or non-uniform motion. The answer is that when magnitude of velocity changes, velocity changes. For example, consider that suddenly the velocity of the car changes from 6 meter per second to 30 meter per second. Secondly, if the direction of velocity changes, we say that the velocity changes. For example, the car takes a turn and start moving in other direction than this direction. Thirdly, when both magnitude or direction of velocity changes, then we say velocity changes. Remember that when velocity changes, acceleration A produces. Let me repeat this important point. When velocity changes, acceleration produces. Keep this important point in your memory. Now let me teach you uniform circular motion. If I hide the word circular, what is left behind? It is uniform motion. Do you understand uniform motion? I hope you can. Now to understand uniform circular motion, let me draw a circle. Let a car is moving on the circular track of this circle, on the circumference of this circle. Let at this point, the speed of this car is 8 meter per second. At this point, the speed of car is again 8 meter per second. At this point, the speed of car is also 8 meter per second. And similarly, here, the speed is again 8 meter per second. Can you guess the type of motion of this car? I am sure you can. At each and every point, the speed of car is 8 meter per second. It means that car covers 8 meter distance every second. Or you can say that car covers equal distance in equal interval of time. Hence, this car possesses uniform speed. Or one can say that car is in uniform motion. Let me repeat it. One can say that car is in uniform motion. We know that this car is moving on a circular track or on a circular path. Hence, this car is in uniform circular motion. Now, how can you define uniform circular motion? Well, it is defined as if an object is moving with uniform speed on a circular track or on a circular path, such type of motion of an object is known as a uniform circular motion. If I ask you, describe the velocity of this car moving on a circular track, can you describe it? Well, we know that the speed of this car or the magnitude of velocity of this car is 8 meter per second. What about the direction of this car? The direction of the car at this point is like this. At this point, the direction of the car is like this. Also, at this point, the direction of the car is like this. And the direction of the car at this point is also like this. Although the speed or magnitude of velocity of the car is same uniform or constant, but the direction of velocity of the car is constantly changing at each and every point. We have learned in the previous slides that when the direction of velocity changes, we say that velocity changes. When velocity changes, acceleration produces in an object. Thus, this car is accelerating around the circular track at each and every point, because the direction of this car is constantly changing. Now, if I ask you that in which direction this car is accelerating, to learn and understand this question, you must understand circular motion. Thus, understanding circular motion. Let consider that mass M is attached to a string. Let this mass M is revolving in a circular path. Here the string exerts force on the mass. As a result, this mass M is rotating in a circular path. If I cut this string or let suddenly this string is cut down, what will happen to the circular motion of this mass M? Well, the mass M will move in a straight path if string is cut down. Thus, we can say that it is string which compels this mass M to move in a circular path. Thus, this string exerts force F on this mass towards center, and mass M moves in a circular track. Therefore, whenever you see an object is revolving around a circle or move on a circular track, think that there is force on the object towards center, due to which the object is moving around a circular track. This force which compel an object to move on a circular track is known as a centripetal force. Centripetal force is denoted by FC. Centripetal force is also known as a center-seeking force. It means it is acting on an object towards center. Now, according to Newton's second law, F is equal to ma. It means whenever there is net force F acting on mass m, acceleration A will produce in mass m due to force F. Hence, this mass m moving on a circular path is also accelerating due to centripetal force FC. So, any body moving around a circular track is accelerating or possesses acceleration due to centripetal force FC. Remember that acceleration produced in a body due to centripetal force is known as a centripetal acceleration. Centripetal acceleration is denoted by AC. The formula of centripetal acceleration is AC is equal to V squared upon radius. Remember this very important point. Both centripetal force and centripetal acceleration are towards the center. It means that both the direction of centripetal force and centripetal acceleration is towards the center. For centripetal force, we rewrite the Newton's second law of motion. FC is equal to m. Instead of a, we put centripetal acceleration. A is equal to v squared upon r. The centripetal force is equal to mass into velocity squared upon radius. One last bonus point is that there is big difference between F is equal to ma and FC is equal to mv squared upon radius. Remember that F is a linear force and A is linear acceleration of mass m. When F acts on mass m, linear acceleration A produces. While FC is centripetal force and AC is centripetal acceleration and mass m. When FC acts on mass m, centripetal acceleration AC produces and mass m. Note down that the direction of centripetal force and centripetal acceleration will always be towards the center. This was all about uniform circular motion. If you have learned something new in this lecture, like this video and subscribe our channel for more conceptual lectures. Thank you very much for watching this lecture.